If you or someone you love is dealing with that constant ringing, buzzing, or humming in the ears, today's video is for you. We're diving into something that's gaining more attention in the research, your diet, and how it might be influencing your tinnitus. Can what you eat actually affect the ringing in your ears? Let's dig into the evidence and find out. Hi. I'm Dr. Layne Garrett, founder of Timpanogos Hearing and Tinnitus, where over the last 20 plus years, we've helped thousands of people overcome their hearing and tinnitus problems. Tinnitus affects more than 750 million people around the world, and it can be mildly annoying or totally overwhelming. According to the American Tinnitus Association, tinnitus is the perception of sound when there's no external sound present, commonly described by patients as ringing, buzzing, or static. Now here's what's important. Tinnitus isn't just an ear problem. It's often tied to how your brain processes sound. That's why we take a full body, full brain approach in our clinic and in my book. This includes sound therapy, hearing technology, cognitive strategies, and increasingly lifestyle factors like diet. In 2025, a major study published in BMJ Open looked at 15 common dietary factors and their association with tinnitus across 300,000 participants. What they found was fascinating. Four specific dietary habits were associated with lower tinnitus prevalence. One, fruit consumption lowered your risk by 35%. Dietary fiber lowered it by 9%. Caffeine lowered it by 10%, and dairy products lowered it by 17%. These aren't small numbers. And while this study doesn't improve that diet causes or cures tinnitus, it gives us clear cues that diet really does matter. If you could do me a favor, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. That way you'll never miss a new video that we post, and it helps others find our channel. Let's talk about why food might be impacting your tinnitus. Well, better blood flow. Fruit and fiber support cardiovascular health. More blood flow means a better, healthier inner ear structure. Two, less inflammation. Antioxidants found in berries, leafy greens, and dairy help reduce oxidative stress in the auditory system. Blood sugar regulation. Fiber helps manage glucose and insulin levels, which can affect your cochlear health. And neurochemical balance. Caffeine may actually help support dopamine levels in the brain when used moderately. We're not talking about magic blueberry pills that cure tinnitus. We're talking about a healthy whole food diet that supports your auditory system and brain health. So what about foods we should be mindful of? That same study also looked at fats, sugars, meat, eggs, and chocolate, but results were inconclusive. Still, other research suggests that high sugar diet may promote inflammation. Saturated fats could impair circulation to the inner ear, and MSG, artificial sweeteners, or high sodium could also be individual triggers. That's why I encourage patients to keep a food and symptom journal. See what your unique body is telling you about food and tinnitus. The American Tinnitus Association agrees, diet is a valid lifestyle factor. But like everything with tinnitus, it's individualized. Some patients are very reactive to certain foods, others not so much. What matters is consistency, curiosity, and science-informed approach. Start small. Add a piece of fruit every day. Swap white bread for whole grain bread. Choose water over too much soda. Take processed snacks out for something that has protein and fiber. This isn't a diet, it's a sustainable shift towards better health for your ears and your brain and your body in general. So what are some practical takeaways here? Well, first, eat the rainbow, colorful fruits and veggies. Prioritize fiber, whole grains, legumes, and nuts. Use healthy fats, olive oil, try some avocado, add some omega-3s. Moderate your caffeine. Coffee can be okay for many, but that same article found if you go over about 3 cups of coffee or the equivalent energy drink or more than 44 ounces of cola a day, now we're starting to get a little bit too much. Cut down processed food. Avoid MSG, trans fats, and lots of sugar. Hydrate, especially first thing in the morning, and track your triggers using a journal or an app. And don't forget, these ideas work best when combined with other proven strategies like hearing aids, sound therapy, counseling, mindfulness, and of course, the FDA-approved linear treatment for tinnitus. So, can your diet help tame tinnitus? The research says it can help, and when paired with professional treatment, it's one of the best tools we've got. To learn more about how we treat tinnitus, you can visit our website at thebesthearing.com, or you can get a free copy of my book, Take Your Life Back, at freetinnitusbook.com. Links can be found in the description below. Remember, your ears are connected to your brain, your health, and your happiness. Take care of them.